Good morning and welcome to St. John the Baptist. Before we begin our celebration this morning of worship, please take a moment to silence and turn off all cell phones. Please join in our entrance hymn, which can be found in the Missal number 80, All People That on Earth Do Dwell, number 80, found in the Missal. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, the Lord said, "The outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is so grave that I must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I mean to find out." While Abraham's visitors walked on farther toward Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew nearer and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city. Would you wipe out the place rather than spare it? For the sake of the 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die with the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Abraham spoke up again, "See how I am presuming to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes? What if there are 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of the 40. Then Abraham said, "Let not my Lord grow impatient if I go on. What if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find but 30 there." Still Abraham went on, "Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? The Lord answered, "I will not destroy it for the sake of the 20. But still he persisted, "Please let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there?" He replied, "For the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, on the day I A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, you were buried with him in baptism, in which you were also raised with him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And even when you were dead in transgressions and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he brought you to life along with him, having forgiven us all our transgressions, obliterating the bond against us with its legal claims, which was opposed to us. He also removed it from our midst, nailing it to the cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and when he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone in debt to us. And do not subject us to the final test." And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend to whom he goes at midnight and says, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived at my house from a journey, and I have nothing to offer him.' And he says in reply from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children and I are already in bed. I cannot get up to give you anything.' I tell you, if he does not get up to give the visitor the loaves because of their friendship, he will get up to give them whatever he needs because of his persistence. And I tell you, ask and you will receive. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. What father among you would hand his son a snake when he asks for a fish, or hand him a scorpion when he asks for an egg? If you then, who are wicked, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? The Gospel of the Lord. Well, in thinking and praying about what I wanted to say today, a number of thoughts came to my mind, as you can expect. And I thought, well, you know, some friends I was with the other day, they said, Father, you know, we know it's been, you know, a very emotional time for you. And of course, the love and support has been amazing, amazing from all of you, all the community, all my friends. Overwhelming, in fact. So overwhelming that I thought to myself, what on earth can I really say? What words could express my gratitude, my appreciation to God and to the community and to my 25 years of the priesthood and 13 here at the parish? All these thoughts, so many thoughts. And I thought, well, then my friend said, well, you know, Father, sometimes there are no words. And I said, you know, you're right. Sometimes there are no words. But then I thought, well, but I can't just say that and say, please stand for the creed, right? I thought, well, that gets me off the hook. I don't really need to preach a homily. I can just say, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, there are no words. I couldn't do that. I mean, I thought about it, right? And then, of course, looking at the gospel, I saw in the very last line the inspiration. The Holy Father in heaven will give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him. So, come Holy Spirit, fill our minds and hearts with the words that we need to say. And in a certain sense, as I reflected upon that experience, it's true that some situations there are no words, humanly speaking, right? But thanks be to God that we have the divine words, the words of God, the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, which is really, of course, on this Sunday, as I prepare to move on to a new assignment, our time together has been precisely that, not so much the human words which have been preached and spoken and offered for your instruction and your encouragement and inspiration, but what has united us in this blessed friendship for 13 years is the Word of God and the Holy Spirit. And it's not about me, it's about the gospel, and it's about the church, and it's about the priesthood, not just me, Father, but the priesthood of Jesus Christ. It's about the sacraments. It's about all that we have shared together these past 13 years for me. Some of you, I know, are more recent arrivals to the parish community. Welcome, if it's only been the past few years or so. Some of you, of course, were here way before I even arrived, right? The long and glorious 60-plus year history of our parish community now, right? So, my own words, but ultimately the Word of God, the inspiration that we've all received from the gospel. This is why we are so grateful and so appreciative for our time together, and why we will always, always remain united, united in our prayer, our love for one another, and our work on behalf of God's kingdom, right? So, let's go back a little bit, the story. 2009, July, 13 years ago, July 2009, I make a very significant change in my life at that point. I move from St. Michael's Abbey, where I had served as the novice master in charge of the formation of our seminarians for 12 years, to the parish. And I arrive, let's see, if, you know, of course, you kind of, you know, the more mature and experienced parishioners here will recognize these names. I was the young priest back then, right? And I joined a community that included Father Hildebrand, Father Norbert, Father Robert, Father Philip, and Father Andrew, who's the only one of that group of five that's still here and with me. Right? Those names familiar to some of you, yes. The former pastor, the former... So when I arrived, again, as sort of the new priest, the young priest, of course, I was entrusted with a number of different ministries, and that began my particular journey here. And this is where I can say, you know, my friends are right when they say, Father, there really are no words. In the way that I have been blessed, especially in my years here at the parish, having just celebrated my 25th anniversary as a priest, obviously that gave me plenty of time to reflect on the blessings of all 25 years, certainly. But now today and this weekend, it's about the last 13 years. And now, of course, you know, recommending my new ministry to your prayers, as I'm sure we will always remain praying for one another, for this next big change in my life. So it was from abbey to parish, and now it's from Costa Mesa back to the Midwest. Some of you, many of you may know, I'm from Wisconsin originally, right? But I never really did well in winter. It's fun when you're a child, right? It's fun when you're a kid, but then when you're an adult, it gets really annoying and frustrating and difficult sometimes, with all due respect to those listening back home in the Midwest on my live stream. Anyway, so for reasons of continuing education and especially the warm weather and other things, I came to California in 1987. And of course, 3 years later, I was at St. Michael's Abbey and happily began my formation in my life as a Norbertine, right? So, but now, of course, going back to Wisconsin and Illinois, Springfield, Illinois, to be precise, where our Abbey community here in California is beginning a new community, which will officially begin next summer, but I'm going early to do all the preparation to prepare for that community's start. Now going back, obviously many, many thoughts in my mind, and especially for the way in which this time at St. John the Baptist, again, from all of those original priests, obviously we remember the Mercy Sisters, Sister Vianney, my goodness, thank you for everything, dear sister. You are very much remembered and loved. So for all the ways in which the ministry here has been, for me personally, well, of course, first the challenge of being named the pastor, and then doing my best to do my best job as pastor and experiencing the tremendous blessings, the growth of our community. And I think personally as a priest, obviously in my role of preaching the gospel, administering the sacraments, obviously this week and in the next few days, I'm still here. I leave precisely, just for your information, I leave Friday morning, so I'm here through Thursday. All of the baptisms, many, many baptisms, of course, some of you here in the church, I baptized or baptized your children. The weddings, see some of you, couples that I've married or friends and family. All the ways in which First Holy Communions, anointings of the sick, the funerals that we've had together, saying goodbye to our dearly departed, our many loved ones. All those memories as a priest for me have become, again, part of the formation of my life, part of my journey, right? Everyone's life has a purpose. It's, we could say, a journey with a purpose. That's what your life is. Your life is a journey with a purpose. And that journey may take you, who knows? For me, it brought me from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to Orange County, California, Costa Mesa, and of course now back to the Springfield. But in all of this, you know, the words of the Our Father that we heard in our gospel today, you know, may God's will be done. He is leading us. And we, when we allow that to happen, when we allow God to lead us in our lives, that's where we find peace and consolation and strength and courage to be His instrument. God's instrument, in whatever vocation, not just priests and sisters, right? For all of you, in your family, at your work, with your friends, God has given us this beautiful task, a vocation, a calling, to live the gospel, to preach the gospel in our words and actions, not only officially here during Mass or other liturgical services, but this is the way in which Our life is constantly giving a lesson to others, whether we're aware of that or not. And I pray that my life among you has given you a positive message, a message of God's love, of God's grace, faith and hope, courage, inspiration, encouragement, all those words. You've heard me preach them 1,000 times, right? In fact, all my friends were saying, Father, you know, we know, like, all of my phrases, like all these things, I say that like 5 times every homily. Truly, just for emphasis, rhetorical, you know, devices and strategies for emphasis. But in all these things, yes, there again, I used it again. In all these things, we are mindful of God's blessings, are we not? In all these things, we are always grateful to God. In all the challenges that we've faced these past 13 years, we have continued to build this community, to grow, not only in numbers, but especially in strength, the strength of our faith, our hope, and our love. Our love for God, our love for the church, our love for the truth, our love for the gospel, our love for the sacraments. Everything that we have shared together, obviously that will continue on, certainly, as the community will continue to grow. That's obviously my prayer, and that is the mission now entrusted to Father Pascal as your new pastor, and to the other priests here, for sure. But not only looking back and saying, thank you, God, for these past 13 years together, but now looking forward to saying, God, and I know personally that God will continue to bless this community. I'm like always part of the community, right? I'll be coming back to visit occasionally. We'll see how that works out. But be that as it may, wherever God may take me, or wherever God may take you, or wherever God may take us together as a community, when we are following the inspirations of the Lord and the Holy Spirit, then we know we are fulfilling God's will. We know we are accomplishing His work. And there is great joy in doing that. And so, as you've known these past weeks, on a human level, it's been very difficult, obviously, to say goodbye to so many wonderful friends, so many people with whom I have been blessed to share so much of my life. But again, the bond continues. The bond endures because the bond is in Christ. It is in God, our friendship, all that we have shared together. They are beautiful gifts from God. And that's why even as I prepare to move on, that bond, the blessings that that brings, those are gifts which no distance can, you could say, separate. No distance can break those beautiful bonds that we share as members of the church, members of God's family, God's community. So my prayers obviously will be with you today as we share this Mass together. My prayer, of course, is that God will continue to bless this community, all of you as individuals, families, our friends, and that all the work that we do in God's name, surely, will be inspired by His grace, will be blessed by the Holy Spirit. And thank you for everything that you have done for me personally. Thank you for all your work for the community. And in knowing of God's many blessings, God's great love and care for us, this is why to say, well, farewell is not a final goodbye, and it's an occasion for us moving forward now to really continue to entrust our lives, our work, our joyful purpose in this life to the grace and power of God Himself. Together, let us now make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Jesus promises that our Heavenly Father hears the prayers of those who come before him in faith. Let us now confidently lift up our hearts in prayer.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all bishops and priests, may they be strengthened in their ministry of preaching the message of God's reconciling and healing love to the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations experiencing the harmful effects of violence and war, may they be rebuilt in the peace and justice that comes from living according to the wisdom of God's laws. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are away from the church, especially within our own families, may they respond to the Lord's call for repentance and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick and suffering, especially Martha Hernandez, Dick Redoubte, the A.J. Messicini family, William West, Alex Mueller, and Martha Garduño, may they receive healing and comfort from Christ our Redeemer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our loved ones who have died, especially Alma Ramirez, Nina Merlino, and Kan Tai Jap, mother of our Father Damien, may they be welcomed into the joy and peace of eternal life with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions submitted to our St. John's Prayer Line ministry, and for all those we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us. We pray also this morning for the repose of the soul of Jaime Castro Perez, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, inspire us with greater confidence in the power of prayer, and fill us with the joy of being disciples of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is found in the Missal, number 189, Lord of All Hopefulness, number 189, found in the Missal.
Lord of all joy, whose joy
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, as with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Ton as assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Never forget all his mercy.
Our first communion hymn is found in the hymnal, number 1032, Humbly We Adore You. Number 1032, found in the hymnal.
Mystery, in you are made one.
Number 1028, Beautiful Savior, found in the hymnal number 1028.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for the announcements. First of all, employment opportunity here at St. John the Baptist. Our school is looking for a new maintenance worker. So, in the bulletin, you'll see detailed information. We are looking for a new skilled maintenance worker, an urgent need to fill this position. School starts in a few weeks. So, again, the information is there in the bulletin for that opportunity for you or, of course, someone you know. So today is my last Sunday. As I mentioned, I'm here until Friday morning, but like booked, right? So, and in fact, last weekend, of course, well, there have been gatherings like all, you know, the last few weeks. So then there was a gathering last night, and someone said, "Father, how you doing?" I'm like, "Well, I mean, it's a lot." And they said, "Father, you must be exhausted. Are you exhausted?" And I said, "No, exhausted was last weekend. What's beyond exhausted? What I don't know if there's a word for that, that's kind of where I am now. Caffeine is really my good friend these days, just to keep me going. So, but after this Mass and all afternoon, I'll be like in the hall. There'll be food available. There'll be a little reception, photo opportunities, all of that good stuff. Then I have the 5 p.m. Mass tonight. And then at, I made the schedule, right? I scheduled myself for the 5 p.m. Mass, my last Sunday evening Mass, because then there's going to be a big party in the courtyard. So again, afternoon, find me in the hall. Tonight, find me in the courtyard, food, beverages, mariachi, live music, the whole thing. So that's our little festival is tonight. Regarding the festival, a number of people have asked about my successor, Father Pascal. He said, well, Father, does he play the electric guitar? And I said, well, no, so you could either invest in some guitar lessons for Father Pascal, or I'm planning to be back for the festival. I've got to be back for the festival, for sure. Thank you. Well, anyway. Yeah, so we'll see. I'll be planning on being back for the festival. Okay, so again, afternoon reception in the hall, evening party in the courtyard, and again, words, there are no words. Words cannot express, there are no words to say thank you, and thanks, of course, to God for our many years together. In addition to all of the sacred moments that I mentioned in the homily, all the sacraments, the celebrations here in this beautiful church, which again, we've done a lot of like good work on the church. Remember 13 years ago, the church? You couldn't see the tabernacle or access it. Yeah. Now we can, of course, and we raised the altar on this beautiful platform. All the wall imagery, in fact, is, you know, from my time here as pastor. So we've done a lot of beautiful work. And we are expecting this week the arrival of our Michelangelo Pietà. So, no, I know. Well, we were getting worried that it would not arrive before I left. This is my last project, my last gift, like, for the beautification of our church. But we are hoping and expecting that it will arrive maybe even tomorrow. So by the time I go, hopefully I'll get the chance to bless it this week. So anyway. All right, so that's what's going on. And of course, as always, check the bulletin and the parish website for other announcements as well. And now please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares. May God rebuke you, may God, and do thou, Prince of the heavens, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evils of prowling about the world, seeking to move.